Hello, Leo. This is Maxine Taylor with your April 2019 forecast. And oh boy, what a great forecast. Let's talk about it, all right? Let's start right over here in the eighth house of other people's money, other people's values, transformation, metamorphosis, and other people's money and other people's values. Okay. So we have Mercury, the blue planet, and Venus, the pink planet, in that eighth house. Mercury is our conscious mind, and wherever it is, that's what we think about and talk about. So joint finances, we may be discussing it with a spouse or a business partner. We may also be looking beneath the surface at what is really going on. And that is the eighth house on its deepest level. Now, Venus, the pink planet, the planet of love and beauty, wherever it is in our chart, solar chart included, that's what we think is beautiful. That's what we love. And it's in the eighth house of other people's money, blessing it, mutual finances, blessing. So are you investing in stocks? Are you investing in a business partnership and talking about the money? Both Mercury and Venus are in Pisces, which is a very dreamy, inspired sign, until they move into the ninth house. And when they do that, they enter Aries. Mercury moves into the ninth house on the 17th, Venus on the 20th. The ninth house is the big picture. When they're in the eighth house, they're dealing with secrets. They're dealing with details. They're dealing with hidden things. In the ninth house, that's the big picture. And all the pieces of the puzzle that we were working on fall into place in the ninth house. So thinking about travel, thinking about higher education, expressing your ideas, your concepts, your beliefs. Venus, what we love. In the ninth house, our belief system involves love. We love travel. We love talking about concepts and the bigger picture, expanding our horizons. Absolutely beautiful, beautiful. Keep your passport current, because when I say long distance travel, I mean that. Now, the sun, the yellow planet, has been and will stay in that ninth house till the 20th. While it's in the ninth house, that our belief system, our truth, that's the center of our life. The ninth house is publishing, it's writing, it's expressing principles. And so you are a person of principle while that sun is in the ninth house on the 20th, same day that Venus enters the ninth house. So the sun leaves and enters your 10th house of career and is replaced immediately by Venus, and 3 days before that, by Mercury. And so they continue the big picture concept for you. When the sun sits on your midheaven, that's the top of the chart, on the 20th, that is the time to move upward in your career. Because your leadership, your ability to lead, comes alive. It is absolutely beautiful. Now, on the 22nd, the sun and Uranus form a conjunction. They come together. Uranus is innovation, inventiveness, individuality. It is charisma, magnetism. When the sun conjuncts Uranus, you're doing your own thing, and the whole world is seeing it. So my suggestion is, you plan something dramatic for the 22nd, maybe the 21st and the 22nd, Be your own person. Let the world see you. The new you. The new and improved you. Now, Mars is the planet of action and energy. It's in Gemini. Wherever Mars is, that's what comes first to us. That's what we throw ourselves into. Now, the sun is the center of our life. So your career and your public image is the center of your life. But your friends and group activities and what you want for yourself, your hopes and wishes, that comes first. And wherever Mars is, that's what we'll fight with or fight for or both. And so you're fighting with friends, you're fighting for friends. You may be fighting for some organization, a humanitarian or philanthropic organization. This is quite beautiful. Keep up the good fight. Now we have a new moon and a full moon, of course. The new moon is April 5th in 15 of Aries. Find 15 of Aries in your birth chart, because on the new moon, that's when the energy starts moving forward and we can begin our projects. So your ninth house, once again, is activated. I shouldn't say once again, is activated. And you see a bigger picture than you thought you had, more options than you knew that you had. Really great. Your higher mind is activated. And then as the moon keeps growing, it comes to full. And the full moon is on the 19th in 29 degrees of Libra. Find 29 degrees of Libra in your birth chart, because that's where things come to a head. It's not necessarily a negative thing. When things come to a head, that allows you to deal with them. And if you've been working toward a project, let's say in your case, a family event, you'll find that it can come to a head. You can bring it to fruition naturally on the full moon. And because the full moon is 1 degree behind the cusp of the fourth house of home, family, real estate, it activates everything in the fourth house: home, family, real estate, emotional security needs. And so this is the time then to focus on family. Are you thinking of moving? Thinking of building a house? Renting a house? This is a good time to visit family. Now, back in January, we had two eclipses, and we find that eclipses are really at their peak 3 to 4 months after they occur. Well, that's April and May, this month and next month. So let's take a look backwards, because 2020 is a 2020 hindsight. Is what we're looking at. Look at this. On January 15th, we had an eclipse. Let me make sure of the date on that. Excuse me, January 5th. I knew my handwriting was atrocious. January 5th, we had a solar eclipse. That's a new moon. In your sixth house of work, health, and service. And now that area is coming alive so that you can activate this whole sixth house. In your birth chart, what you're going to do is see where it fell and combine it with this wonderful sixth house activation. Then the full moon, the lunar eclipse, on January 21st, fell in 1 degree of Leo, right on your solar ascendant. And when we have an eclipse on our ascendant, our sun, or our moon, this brings in a new life. It's not a new chapter, it's a whole new book. I love it. So I guess what I'm saying is decide what you want to be when you grow up, because it's happening right now. Don't you love it? And of course, work and career are going to be involved. So with that in mind, have a marvelous April. And I look forward to being with you next month when once again I look at your solar forecast. Till then, may the stars shine brightly on you and yours.